So yeah, today I'll be talking about Vista paper, which is diverse benchmarks and training sets for Indian language ASR. So thank you for inviting me to give the session, and thanks for conducting good initiatives like this. So a bit about myself. I'm Kurian Benoy. This is the photo which I go in the internet. I work as an ML engineer at 7AI. I recently joined few days back. I am a volunteer at Swatantra Malayalam Computing at least for a few years. Good friends with Santosh Tottingal and Kavya Manohar and few other folks in that community. And yeah, I have spoken in a few international conferences, especially FOF and Python has been some of my strong points. Spoken in Python India thrice. Also, yeah, like I maintain an open source package called Vistaar Normalizer, which has about total 1,75,000 downloads, and I'm also a creator of Index Subtitling. So yeah, about Vistaar paper. So Vistaar, basically the name itself comes from the Hindi name, Vistaar meaning broad in Hindi. In my mother tongue, Malayalam, it's called Vistaram, or this, and the same thing itself. So it's not just one Hindi word itself. Like, I think probably in a lot of common languages, I don't know, in Malayalam at least, it is having the same meaning. And they call this Vista because, like, they propose this as a collation of benchmarks across various Indian languages as well as various types of data. So that is why I say they take. Call this Vistaar, and whatever sentence which I have put here, like, is directly from the paper, and it comprises of about 12 languages, leading to about 59 word error rate values. And if you are looking for, by the way, I know if anyone of you are not familiar with the term word error rate, I know it's a jargon for some of the people. If you are not in speech world, word error rate is something like in ML world, a metric basically, like accuracy, precision, recall. And how that word error rate as a metric is basically being calculated is like, so in a speech to text model, the speech to text output will obviously, for a speech, obviously there is a ground truth or like the actual output which is to be expected, while an ASR model or a ML model predicts an output, which is called ASR text. And a ground truth. On comparing both of these things with a metric like word error rate, I'm not getting into the detail of it, but comparing this ground truth as well as the ASR output, we get this metric like WER, CUR, CER, and all. And WER basically means word level and character. So it depends on word by word if it is calculating, it's just WER. CER, it is like character. I can go into the formulas and stuff like that, but you know, I'm not getting into it. If anyone is very curious about it, just wanted to explain that. And word error rate as a metric, just like accuracy, always higher is the better. In word error rate, lower value is the better. So maybe when we are looking at some figures and stuff like that, it will be easier for us to understand that. Oh, six people entered the waiting group. So let me admit all of them as well. So, sorry for the delay.
Korean, can you explain the part about where it says leading to 59 computed word error values?
So that I don't have a idea, but like when we read the paper, I think we will get a better idea about that in general, because I have a rough sense of what it is, but okay, how they calculate the exact 59, maybe it is like saying like something just to they are doing for 59 something. My intuition here is like for 59 data sets in 59 domains, they create 59 different word error rates, and based on that they get the value. But yeah, even I am also not exactly sure about that.
Yeah.
Also,
that, so we can just like look into the research paper that you have, that you're sharing with us.
Yep. So Piyush, maybe what I prefer is, like, maybe I can just complete the slides, and after that, like, we can get into a discussion also, if that is fine, because I prefer to go in that flow first, if
yeah,
that is
sure.
Okay for
yeah,
you.
Sure. Yeah, sure.
Thank you, many thank you, Piyush. Yeah. So, alright. Okay, so the abstract of the paper, as you can see, is basically, the research paper emphasizes the need for better automatic speech recognition system so that, it's more like individuals can use large language models, so that, like, basically using ASR and, like, so that, like, with LLMs, it says that it's a crucial idea. And to study, okay, this is something I did, just by, I tried to convert the abstract into third person also when I did the site. So maybe LLM might have hallucinated. Sorry for that. But yeah, like, in an effort to solve this issue, so they basically compiled Vistaar, a collection of 59 benchmarks. So, and that 59 benchmarks in different languages, different language combinations across probably 59 data sets. And it amounts to about 10,700 hours of data. And to study that, and they basically introduce something called as Indic Whisper. Indic Whisper is, like, basically in this large data set, they have actually trained, basically they collected the benchmarking data set, then they collected the training data set, and then they basically trained on it. So let's get into the details. So when we get into the details, and also they even did something else, like to score the benchmark, not just in Indic Whisper alone, like they had to benchmark with basically three open source data sets and two commercial ASR models they benchmarked. And in all these metrics, like 39 hour models, Indic Whisper was the best performing model compared to any other model. And it's a community effort, and all the effort was, like, is accessible by a GitHub link, and the code is available here as well. So if you are interested for the work of AI4Bhārat Vistaar, I will say go to this repository, give them a star for the good work they have done, because I think this is the best work, at least in any speech recognition I have come across in Indian languages. And the dataset is available to download here. Model is available to download here in this language. They have a proper readme as well. So good job for the people who maintain this. And I just wanted to give a shout out to that code repository. Maybe when you are following, you can maybe take a look at this, like, if you find my, yeah. I'm facing some issues with my tech stack, sorry. And yeah, this work got selected for InterSpeech 2023 conference as well. So if you don't know what is InterSpeech 2023 conference, it is, like, one of the best speech conferences across the world. And and in this conference, they got, like, selected. It was happening in Dublin, and I think the first paper authors or some of the people who worked in this went to the conference and attended it in person. So very impressive work. And if you are looking about the authors of the paper, so the first authors of the paper are Kaushal Santosh Bogle and Sai Sundarshan. So Kaushal is a PhD scholar at IIT Madras, and Sai is, like, a BTech student at IIT Kharagpur, but he works in server AI as well. So I know him, and I actually know about that paper also from him, really. And Abhigyan is also a founding engineer who is, like, my colleague at server. Tahi Javed is, like, a PhD scholar at IIT Madras. Then Mitesh M. Krapka, who is, like, a professor at IIT Madras, and Pratish Kumar, who is, like, a co-founder of at Serverwing, is, like, the authors of this paper. So about the paper, Vistaar as a dataset diversity, if you look at it, it just look at, look at this paper, like just look at, what do you say, at this figure for a moment, and it comprises of the types of sources. So there is Wikipedia data, there is news data, there is blogs, there is education stuff. So CV basically means Common Voice. We will get into the details of each of these data set. Probably with that, we might get a better idea about how they derived that 59 language combinations, which Piyush was asking me. Weather, books, navigation, tourism, agriculture, poems, story, science, textbooks, science, literature, health, and website. So these are the data set. In all these, maybe Indic TTS has a lot of diversity, while maybe something like NPTEL. NPTEL we know as an education platform, and they just have education-funded videos. Shruti Lipi was like news. You know, the one thing about this paper is like all these data sets existed previously. What they did is like they collated all these data sets together and they identified training data set and benchmarking data set. So that's what I say basically. So basically out of all this, they created a training data set and benchmarking data set. They identified certain data sets specifically for training, certain data sets specifically for validation, for benchmarking. And what you see here, right? So this figure, okay, now when I looked at the figure one basically covers Vistaar benchmarking data set only. So all the data sets listed here is like a very good thing. And maybe what they are trying to say with this paper is like, rather than creating we need that data diversity in order to get a good ASR model performance. And what the paper is trying to say, as far as I understand, is like, with this figure is like, when we collate all these data sets, we have this much diversity. And with that, they created a good benchmarking data set based on which like we can train any good models. And this training data set, it is consisting of the following 7 data set. If you want to know the details of what are these 7 data set, like it is mentioned here, like basically section 3. Vista train data set. Shruti Lipi consists of read to speech data set collected from covering 12 languages. That is, Shruti Lipi itself is a paper, as far as I understand. NPTEL, IIC, Millay, IIT, MSR, Vakshyant, all these are like different papers, probably, or at least they are sources which have been cited in the paper. So if you want to go into it, like you can go into it. Probably that itself is a loophole to explain. But yeah, like I haven't gone that much in detail into that work. And benchmarking data set, we saw here also all the benchmarking data sets. They say they collected 7 itself for benchmarking. It consists of Kanpath, Kanpath Hard. So Kanpath and Kanpath Hard are being collected by the wonderful Karya.in team, which was featured in Forbes recently, which were saying like they are doing a novel work and stuff like that. So career people collected that data set. Then there is Fluous data set, which is a common speech translation data set from Google, if I understand correctly. Then there is Common Voice. Common Voice data set is from Mozilla. Then there is Indic TTS, MUCS, Gramvani. I have worked maybe with Fluous and Common Voice, other data set I am also relatively new with, so maybe questions and all, even I am also new with it. And if you look at the diversity, maybe I think this is how like that 59 benchmarks over 12 Indian languages came. So if you look at the Vistaar benchmark set, okay, across Bangla, like the various languages, BN probably is Bangla, GU probably is Gujarati, ML is Malayalam, MR Marathi, all those things. You can see that, okay, Vistaar benchmark set consists of 59 benchmarks over 29 languages. And Vistaar train set consists of 10,700 plus hours of data, as we discussed in the abstract of the paper. And that too, across the split is properly being given here. So for example, like, okay, Google TTS data set was like 5 hours, 8 hours. It was not Malayalam only 6 hours. Certain data sets like Korea probably is not even there. So Urdu is not there. So that is how the data set is comprised. And probably Shruti Lipi is the biggest data set. But Shruti Lipi is like a new data set, as far as I understand. And that also, it's like cited in the paper. I might have read the paper, but I don't exactly remember the paper. But I think it's also from the AI4Bhārat team itself. And Indic Whisper, basically, you know what I have written this thing, but what they said is like, in order to improve the ASR thing, like, okay, in Vistaar trained data set, like Vistaar trained data set, they tried in different model architecture. They decided to settle with Whisper model. And they said why they settled with Whisper model is because in Hindi language, they tried it. And in Hindi language, they felt like Whisper is the best model and giving decreasing word error rate best across all the architectures. And what this data structure researchers did is like, it is not a multilingual model necessarily. What they did is like in Indic Whisper, for each language, they trained with Whisper medium. Why they chose medium is also a very good question. I think they haven't answered that in the paper. But yeah, like obviously they might have went with what they could do, right? Because obviously, yeah, resource constraint will be there in the work. And based on that, like they trained the model. And that model weight, which is being trained...
There is a reason for this, by the way.
Yes. Yes, sir.
There is a reason for using Whisper medium. Is because if you look at the Whisper paper, you'll see that the Whisper large and the Whisper medium are not very qualitatively different in terms of the measured WER for a number of languages. So Whisper medium already kind of reaches the peak, let's say, and Whisper large is probably the language which can accommodate more future languages. But I've myself benchmarked Whisper medium and compared it to Whisper large. The gap is very less. Like there is a gap, but it's not that much. So when you're in a resource constrained scenario, Whisper medium is an ideal solution.
Got it. Thank you for sharing that, Dr. Raj. So yeah, and all these models are available here as well. So like this Bankayali, Gujarati, stuff like that is available as well. And yeah, they compared five ASR systems. Indic Wave Vector is also made by AI4Bhārat. Then NVIDIA medium and NVIDIA large. So NVIDIA medium and NVIDIA large are just available in Hindi, and Google and Azure are like, you know, commercial systems. And okay, in Hindi across all these models, you can see that in the various benchmark, Indic Whisper is performing across this split. Like, okay, Indic Whisper has the highest average accuracy, 13.6, while NVIDIA models are in 18 and 19, while the commercial models are performing really bad compared to some of the other models as well. And then there is across multiple languages, the split is there. So Indic Whisper across multiple languages, Google STT, Azure STT, Indic Wave Vec2, and Indic Whisper, they tested it. And, you know, they didn't went with NVIDIA in this diagram because obviously NVIDIA is just available in the... while all others are available in these language combinations, as they mentioned in the paper. And okay, yeah, so that's it. And if you look at the results here also, the same story repeats. Like Indic Whisper is performing better than Indic Wave Vec2, as well as some of the professional ASR models like Google STT. Azure was not there. So maybe because of that, like they decided not to compute the average for certain languages. I think that is mentioned somewhere, like in the paper, I remember it is also being mentioned. So, and yeah, like the source code also, if you look at the source code, very honestly speaking, this source code is not much different, I will say, from the Hugging Face implementation of fine tuning. In fact, it is the same thing. I checked with Sai only. So he said like, it's almost the same thing itself. They haven't done any modifications to the Whisper fine-tuning code, which is available in the Transformers library examples. And in evaluation.py, one very good thing which they have done is like Whisper normalization. This is a discovery which I had during my M.Tech thesis, thankfully due to Kavya Manohar, who found it out. Like Whisper normalizer is such a bad normalizer for any Indian languages, probably for most of the multilingual languages as well. Probably a better one will be Indic NLP library. We are still figuring out the normalization for Malayalam and how well this Indic NLP libraries normalization is working. But, you know, Indic normalizer is something in my package, which I said, like, okay, I also had done one independent work for Malayalam ASR benchmarking. And first I was using Vistaar normalizer, and it claimed like 10 word error rate. And we were like thinking like, hey, Vistaar is so good already to be used in Malayalam. But we later realized with some of the fine-tuned models, like the actual performance when we are using Indic NLP normalizer, like which is being used here, was about word error rate of 50 or something like that. So yeah, that was one thing. And we had this transcribe.py function as well. So yeah, that's transcribe.py also nothing much different, I will say. It's like the same thing. Probably the only thing might, from the Vistaar examples, as far as I know, is like the Indic normalizer factory. Maybe Raj or someone can correct me. But yeah, like in my quick look, that is what I understood. So that's it. And so they believe like they can improve the indicator. Maybe if we have more data, these benchmarks. But like they feel like this Vistaar as a bench, I feel like probably this paper's main contribution, Indic Vistaar, maybe some better model might come in 2-3 years. But maybe that Vistaar as a data set, as a good collection of data set, might last, is my feeling at the moment. And yeah, so, and they said like, okay, the Vistaar created Vistaar training data set of 10,000 hours and Vistaar benchmarking data set, which has like 59 data set combinations across various languages, which is basically this thing, right? Yeah, across this 59 benchmarks across 12 Indian languages. So across all these things, like they, across the data set, they could have computed individual word error rate for each language. And it's a very good work, and it's a very good short paper as well. And maybe finally, I just want to say some story. So I was also doing the same stuff for Malayalam speech recognition language, and probably maybe AI4Bhārat didn't publicize their work. So probably this Vistaar paper, even though it got selected for inter speech, it never came to our radar. And yeah, like only recently I came to know about this paper. So once my thesis is over, I came to know of this paper. Otherwise, I could have cited this paper much more and even did some learnings, or maybe even benchmarked some of our models in Vistaar as well, or compared the Indic Vistaar models as well. That is also something which is in my plan to see how well it really performs in Malayalam. So with that, thank you. And I'm open for